Welcome back to the Club Space program. Today we launch a mysterious rocket that you guys don't know about. Bum bum bum. When I open the payload bay, you'll see it. It's pretty boring.
Ooh.
But I mean, why not, you know? Just nothing fancy. I'm not launching a space station. Or am I?
Not yet.
Am I launching a lander for the moon? Maybe, probably not. Lander for Minmus? That's a moon. Am I going to Eve?
Ooh. That's my choice right there. I think he's going to you.
He thinks I'm going to Eve.
Yeah, maybe I got
Comment
some
down below what
insider
you think I'm going,
information.
where you think I'm going. Okay. Yeah, all right. This happens occasionally. It's good. We're all good. It's okay. Watch this. We burn here and we can pick up back we can pick back up at prograde. I promise you guys, it happens all the
That
time.
is
Look at
crazy.
that. I'm telling you. I told you guys, it's gonna work out fine. You didn't believe me.
Bring three tourists to visit an asteroid.
I don't even know where asteroids are.
We got a couple, you know,
Have we tracked them
out
yet?
there. Yeah, we're tracking them.
Everything
And I.
is A-okay. I'm going really slow. It's a feature that I've programmed into this rocket.
It's a feature. And asteroid tracking is actually working. We don't have a million asteroids this
Oh,
time.
so last time we tried to play this, for some reason, well, we know the reason, but
Yeah.
asteroids never stopped populating. So we get to the point where we have like 1,200 asteroids orbiting near us, and we couldn't do anything about it, and they were just there. And it's every time we opened the tracking station or like went to map view, it just freaked out for like
Lag.
10 seconds.
Horrible. Horrible lag. We actually have an asteroid that's pretty close to us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I see what's going on here. My app. Jeez. Okay, I'm sorry, guys. This is just bad. Let's see if we can burn back. Come on. Oh, no, I need to go to 90, don't I? Yeah, I need to go to 90. I need to have going the wrong way. I'm about to be in a polar orbit on accident. All right, that's fine. So time to see the payload. I don't even know what the payload is. Ta-da! These are long distance communication satellites. We already have one out there. I figured I'd show you this one. I don't know why we're spinning. I just given up on at this point. We're gonna go boop. There we go. So I guess we point prograde, right? Is that what we do in this situation? I'm in
Sounds
such
about
a weird
right.
orbit. So, this is the orbit we're going for. And we're in, like, I have plenty of Delta V in this stage. But we're in quite the orbit. So, if we do, like, a maneuver node here, and just kind of kick me back up a little bit, that's 1,000 Delta V to do that. So, we're not going to do that. We're just going to go in orbit the normal way, the confusing way. What a launch. This is spectacular. You guys are so proud. So we're just gonna do that. And our new friend, the flight computer, does everything for us. It's great. It's really you can't use it when you have a crewed station. Oh, shoot, I didn't do this again. There it goes. I always forget to activate this engine. Whoopsie. So we're a little bit behind on the maneuver. That's okay. It's all okay. This mission's just gone to crap real quick.
We'll be fine.
We will be fine. So let's see. We already have one out here. This guy? Yeah, Cygnus 1.0. It's the same exact setup as this, and I'll go over the setup once we get to our destination. But yeah.
Are you doing the satellite in orbit of Kerbin?
Yes, the one that's like 38 million meters out.
Okay, perfect. After you do that, I'm going to take the, I guess, the investor tour mission.
Oh, boy. Okay, so we're looking at that. So if we go here, add maneuver, just go prograde, we should just shoot ourselves straight at that. Close. Close. Whoop, too far. So let's do that. If we move it down, perfect. Okay, let's execute that, and then let's move towards it. And then in the meantime, I'll talk about this. So, okay, give me, yeah, okay, so this one's already targeting Kerbin. So, these guys are the meat and potatoes. So they can reach definitely to the sun. Sometimes past sun, depending on the planet. Like, it'll tell us right here, no target. So let's see. Eve is, can we get out of the way? Like, Eve is 23 gigameters away, and this antenna range is 75. Duna's 7.1, Drez is 57, Joule's 52, Lathe is 52, all that stuff. ELU's 107. So ELU's the only place in the solar system we cannot reach with these antennas. Yeah. So it's pretty nice to have. Just floating around out there. But since immediately we're going to be going, the two planets, definitely Eve is the first planet we'll be going to.
Yeah.
So we'll do that. And then I've been setting this one for Duna, because Duna is also fun to go to. And then these are more local system satellites. And so we're going to target Zamun for one, and then we're going to target the other Cygnus craft, but this one. Yeah, it's cool. We're using these cryogenic rocket engines, which use LH2 and oxidizer at a 15-to-1 ratio, which they give you a ton of delta V, as you can see. And they have gold tanks, so, I mean, it's like a win-win. And I like I wish radiators were a bigger part of the game. I was telling D Fortune about this a while ago. Because if you look at the ISS on the backside of their solar panels, they're just constantly glowing bright red, or orange almost, as they radiate heat off the solar panels. But these, they don't glow, which is upsetting.
Oh, they don't. I never even realized that. I never use radiators, so.
Well, radiators will glow red. If you have big space stations, you really should have them. But the solar panels don't glow. So I just bring radiators just because, I mean, why? They have no purpose, but I want them to have a purpose, so I'm going to make them have a purpose and bring them. Yep. So after this, we'll have our nice, super long-range telecommunications setup. So that way, I know there's a couple missions that have been popping up telling us to go to Eve, do some things. We're not ready for that yet, but whenever we are, this will be ready for us. Cygnus 1.1, 1.0 and 1.1. All right. No, we didn't quite. Can we just burn a little bit more? We didn't quite make it there. That's where I want to be. Add maneuver. So this guy is what's gonna do that. No, we need to be going like that. Uh-huh. It's actually really cheap to do inclination burns when you're super far away from a planet. That's why this is only like a 200 delta V maneuver, and you saw me trying to do this inclination burn at like 100 meters, and it was like 1200 delta V. 100 kilometers. Sorry. I confused myself. Cool. So I think that'll be all right. Let's go ahead and execute that. And whenever you hit the execute button, now it is programmed in the flight computer. So if it loses signal ever, which now anywhere around Kerbin won't necessarily, but say we're actually going to what are those things? Other planets. We will lose signal along the way because nothing's going to be really pointing at them unless we launch another one of these that always is pointing at your active vessel, which isn't a bad idea now that I think about it. But this is really just communications from planet to planet is what I was thinking behind these. So let's get on out there. I'm sure there'll be more missions for satellites that have really high periapsis and apoapsis. So no worries. And we can target one to active vessel and every little thing will be all right. Wow, I mean, we're still 4 days away.
How heavy is this thing? 7 tons. Okay, let's make it bigger, longer.
Faster, stronger.
Yeah, there we go. Corridor docking port. What?
So what are you working on right now, D?
Kerbin Space Station / Casino / Hotel / Space Camp.
Do we know the altitude it needs to be at?
No.
I'm sure you can Google that, right? Hit it with the old Googles. Should be on Google.
Actually, I'm not sure if because I know some of the data for like those contracts are generated whenever you pick them up, so I'm not sure. Let's see. KSP, Space Camp, it doesn't matter. You just have to be in orbit.
Okay.
But the casino.
I thought the Space Camp did matter, but maybe I'm remembering wrong.
At least not the one that we have right now.
Okay. Quick add maneuver here. And this is where we get all set up nice. Still gotta shrink a little bit. Oh wait, this is weird. What's going on? Yeah, so it's 0 degrees. Oh, we're way too big still. Okay. That makes sense. A little bit bigger. Whoop. That'll do. Execute. And burns are so cheap out here. It's like being a min-miss when you're this far away from Kerbin. So, I think it's time to rename this puppy. Cygnus 1.1. Now, Cygnus is a major constellation, and these are really satellite constellations, kind of, if you look at it like that. So that's the nomenclature behind Cygnus.
So it looks like Station Core. Let's make this.
Looks like what?
Nobody's saying how far or what type of orbit the casino or hotel needs.
Okay, so how about we make the executive decision?
Let's see. Kerbin Space Station just has to be below 250 kilometers.
The space station has to be below 250 kilometers?
Yeah.
Oh, darn. I was kind of wanted to put it higher than that. Let's push it to its max then. 200, between 200, like around 200 maybe?
Yeah, I'm down with 200. Let me do this investor tour and then we should be able to see what we need to be at.
Ah, Cygnus 1.1. Cool. Calibration complete. It's there. So we have Cygnus 1.1 and Cygnus 1. Cygnus 1 is in a close to an equatorial orbit, but it's reversed, which is really nice. It's going to be nice to have these two on opposing orbits. Should pretty much always have connection. I don't think there'd be a point where we wouldn't have connection. All right. Let's shut her down. Ah, it's so cool still.
So, do you want to go, I don't know if we decided, casino or hotel?
I wanted to do hotel, but remember you flipped them?
Yeah. Well, we got the mission again, so we got another chance.
All right, let's do hotel.
Hotel.
Okay, cool. Well done. So I think what we'll do now is we'll go back to the Space Center. And there's some interesting missions that we have to do. So maybe I'll finish this episode with a build for one of those missions, and then we can launch it next at the beginning of next episode. Because I'm trying to keep the episode short for you guys. Shorter. Because I know sometimes you don't have time to watch a 40-minute episode. So let's see the contracts. It's active. Minmus Space Station, plant a flag on Minmus.
There you go.
Land on Minmus. Launch the Kerbal Space Station. Launch the Moon Space Station. I think we're fighting that battle against Minmus. I think I know where we need to go.
Yeah. The war. The war against Minmus for taking Jim from us.
The war against Minmus. So I guess we'll build the lander in this episode. We'll do a live build. So you can see the intricate details. Ooh.
Okay, so we're looking for Surewise. Who's Surewise?
So we had the Vega 5 is what took us to orbit Minmus. And that did a good job. But I think the Vegas series is getting a new member. The Vega 6. And I don't want to use the Vega forever. The second we start leaving the Kerbin system, we'll probably change up the nomenclature. But anyway, we definitely want that. So let's build the return part first. So we have thermal, heat shield. I love the unpainted heat shield look. Well, hold on. We need to bring back some science too, don't we? So, seismic impact hammer? Huh. That's interesting. That'd be
cool.
Yeah,
but you need the sensor as well to go with it.
Seismic sensor? Yeah, I'll have to look into that. But how would we bring back science? Like that? Just stick it on top, looking all weird-like? I think so. So, we have better solar panels now? Yes, we do. Perfect. So we're gonna stick one on there. These won't need communications because there'll be people there. But I like to bring one just in case. So the best direct we still have is a 16, Communitron 16, right?
No, technically we have the Comtech, but it's not active in the beginning, so
the Comtech.
You'd have to plan around that.
Where is the Comtech? Oh, like the dishes and stuff?
It looks like a little black circle.
Oh, that guy. Yeah. Okay. No, yeah. We don't need that guy. So we'll do this. Whoop. Perfect. So this is the only thing that we'll be returning. So if that is the case, we need parachutes for sure. So let's get two drogue chutes. And two radial mount parachutes. Perfect. And it's gonna have to decouple. Oh, we got the docking ports, yay. The corridor docking ports, are those, we should use those, I think. Are those the ones that like dissolve once you dock to them?
I don't think so. Those are, I don't think we've gotten those yet.
All right, there we go. Metal. Ooh, that's cool look. All right, so that's our reentry. We're bringing back the science. We have one antenna. That's all we need. Yeah. So I'm thinking we get ourselves a fuel tank. You're a big boy, but I think you might be what we need. So we have that and then engines.
Okay. Investor tour done.
Skipper? No, that's way too powerful. We need the most efficient engine. Probably gonna be the Terrier. So how much delta V does that give us in a vacuum? 15.91, that's entirely more than what we need. So what do we need? Fuel tanks. So what about one of the, oh, stay there. That and that. 918, that's plenty to get off and return home. From Minmus, right?
How much?
918 meters per second.
Yeah, that should be enough to get off and come back.
I don't like it when you say should be, because every time you say should be, you end up stuck, so I'm going to bring more. So we'll bring 1500, that's definitely, or 1600, that's definitely enough.
Space Hotel and the, Space Station have to be two different things.
They do?
Yeah, Space Hotel is above 350 kilometers.
Dang, okay. Well, let's just do the other boy then. So here's where I'm thinking we do things a little different. So I like being different, you know? So we're gonna do this. Fuel tanks. One of these fuel tanks. Yeah, sure. One of these fuel tanks. With the little cap on it. Mm-hmm. And then the engines. Oh, we don't have the small engines yet, do we?
Not yet, no.
And thuds are just way too powerful for what I need them to do. So here's an idea. We don't do this. This is all my builds are. This is why half the time you're watching the fast forwards and it's just me sitting here staring at this, confused. So I mean, do we go Apollo style? Nah. It's too difficult.
You could.
So we're definitely going to need... Okay. Let's think critically about this problem we have here. I did like the coupling out like that. How much science does it take to get? We probably won't be able to get the small engines, huh?
No, I think they're 90.
Okay. So, fuel tanks, let's bring these guys back. Let's put that on top, and then we can use... Pugs. And let's just cut their thrust like 50%. Did that do for all of them? It did. So it's 55.55 thrust weight ratio. Which I think will be just dandy. Okay. Tons of Delta V in this guy. And it's all pretty lightweight. So, I told you I like making weird and random things. So, we need landing struts. I think we'll just go like that. Start retracted. Well, actually, to save space, we'll just start like that. And they extend out. Oh, that's fun. I like that. Okay. And up here, no, one. This is where the fun stuff is going to happen. So we're going to have our science. Science Junior is so big. Do I need two Science Juniors? I don't think so. And then we're going to have... payloads, service bay, no, service module, nope. All right, let's just go with this one then, and open her up. Well, here, well, there we go. Okay, let's see, how's this video going? 29 minutes? Alright, so I think once we fill out these guys, we'll cut away. And then I'll build the rest of the boy. What am I looking for? Structural, yada yada yada, this. This is what I want. Yes. Perfect. Now we definitely need to bring a battery out there. Or two. by possibly 100. Let's see that.
Can people move through batteries?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
So, actually, you got me thinking. No, that's... I don't like doing that. No. Oh. Okay. So I think actually we'll cut here, and I'll do some critical thinking, come up with a plan, and show you guys next time. Adios.